This video will show you how to use general admission holds during ticket creation and management to limit the number of tickets available for your general admission event. We will cover how to add a hold on general admission tickets and how to manage and sell from a hold. Holds remove tickets from public sale. Use them when you want to hold tickets for certain customers, like employee tickets or contest winners. Holds are only available if you set a total capacity for your event. If your organization has set roles and permissions, you will need a role with managed tickets, managed ticket holds, and view ticket holds event permissions. This can be found in the team management section of your organization settings. From the event dashboard, click Tickets on the left side. Select a paid or free ticket type. Complete the ticket creation process as needed. Make sure you set the total event capacity by clicking on the Event Capacity section, then checking the Limit Capacity box, and set your amount. Once you have the event capacity set, click on Holds at the top, and then click Add Hold. An edit window will open where you can enter the name of your hold and quantity of tickets held. These can be changed at any time. You can add an access code for people to be able to purchase or register online under this hold. Click Add Hold, enter a code name. This is what attendees will enter in the promo code area during checkout. You can also set limits to the number of tickets that are available in the code, add a discount, set dates the code is available, and finally, limit which tickets are available with the code. It's important to note that if you don't set a ticket limit or expiration date, the code will be usable as long as there are held tickets. You can edit your hold by going to the Hold tab and clicking the three dots to the right and choosing Edit, where you can change the name of the hold and the quantity available. To update the access code, click the three dots to the right of the name of the access code and choose Edit. You can also delete or copy a URL that is a unique link with the code already activated to share with others. Here is an example of holds being used. You've created two tickets, a general admission with a quantity of 500 tickets available and a VIP with a quantity of 100 tickets available, and you have set your event capacity to 600. Next, add your hold. Let's say it's a radio contest winner with 10 tickets associated with the VIP ticket access. Add your access code with a 100% discount and apply it to the VIP ticket. Your general admissions tickets sell out and all 10 held tickets are claimed. You will only be able to sell 90 VIP tickets since you've set an event capacity of 600, so you won't exceed the 600 tickets. To view the hold details, go to Holds, and you will see how many holds are remaining in your selection. If you click on the hold name, you will also see usage details for the access code. By clicking the three dots next to the hold, you will have the option to release any remaining available tickets back to public sale. To view usage in your reporting, you can see who has used a code by viewing your attendee summary. Click on the columns and select discount code and click update report. This will show you who has used any access code or promo code in your event. For a quick glance at your sales, view the sales by ticket type on your event dashboard where holds are listed as ticket types. You will see your general admission ticket type, VIP ticket, and radio contest winner VIP, as well as how many tickets are sold for each. And that's it. For more help planning your next event with Eventbrite, visit our Help Center, blog, or YouTube channel.